Welcome to this lesson on the OSI model. This is a fairly complex topic, but I'm going to try and break it down and make it as simple as possible. And it's a very, very important concept to understand. So this model is known as the Open Systems Interconnection Model, OSI, and it's used in networking very readily, and you're going to hear it referred to all the time. People are going to talk about things like layer 7 load balancers, layer 4 load balancers, what's happening at layer 2. And if you don't understand what that means, then that's going to put you at a disadvantage. So let's see what the OSI model is all about. Now, I'm going to show you visually so that you can understand and see the various different layers of the OSI model. And we're going to have a look at an example of where a computer here on the left-hand side is communicating with a web server. And we're going to see the different layers that are happening in the OSI model. Now, this is really fairly abstract. It's a reference model, if you like, and it shows us the different layers at which networking operates. So on the left-hand side, we have, to start with, we have the physical layer. Fairly straightforward to understand. This is physical components, things like the ports that you plug a cable into. We then have switches. Now, I say layer 2 switch here, I'll explain that to you in a moment, but at the physical layer, it's a physical device. It's actually a piece of equipment. You can pick it up and hold it. It has some ports in it. You can plug cables into it. Cables as well are physical devices. So that's layer 1. We also have the physical network interface card. That's the connection on the computers on either side of this connection here. Of course, we have to have a network adapter in the computer. A cable gets plugged into that. It goes into a switch or a routing device. There could be many different devices if this is over the internet between them. But this is all physical layer stuff, and we've got communication happening here with electronic signals. Layer 2 of the OSI model is called the data link layer. Here we have the first addressing. We have something called a media access control address. That's an address that is actually associated with the network interface card. And we have the Ethernet protocol. So Ethernet is the most commonly known networking protocol. And it's running down here at layer 2. It's also referred to as 802.1x. So what's happening at layer 2? Well, I mentioned that this switch at the bottom here, which is just a networking interconnection device, is running at layer 2. So the reason it's running at layer 2 is because it's looking at those MAC addresses. So layer 2 MAC addresses are a type of addressing on the network. So if one system needs to find another system, it needs to know what its MAC address is. And what the switch does is it creates a MAC address table. And that says, well, I've got 4 ports on this switch. And I know that MAC 1, let's say that's the one on the left here, is out port 1. And I know that MAC 2 is out port 2. Simple. Or port 4 in this case, on the right hand side. So it's just creating a table that defines where these MAC addresses are, which port on the switch are they associated with, and now it can make sure that it sends the connections out the correct ports. So that's what's happening at layer 2. Next we have layer 3. This is the network layer. Here we have all of the routing infrastructure on the internet, and we have IP addresses. So an IP address is a layer 3 address, and the routers are layer 3 devices. They have a table very similar to the layer 2 switch, but they use IP addresses, so they're layer 3. So they are actually routing connections across the internet based on the IP addresses. They know which interfaces different networks are associated with. And there are complex routing protocols that run at this layer to make sure that the connection across the internet finds the best path to the destination. Above that, we have layer 4. This is the transport layer. We have here TCP, so you've probably heard of TCP/IP before. TCP is the transmission control protocol, and it's associated with the IP addresses as well. And with TCP, we have a three-way handshake. That means first, we have this thing called SYN, synchronize your sequence bits. It's just computer talk for how the connection is made and established. Okay, so we say SYN, an acknowledgement comes back, and then we get an acknowledgement back from the source to the destination, and a connection has been established. Okay, so this is a connection-oriented protocol. It's constantly checking and doing this back and forth to make sure the connection is working, it's established, and it's continuing to run correctly. We also have something called UDP, and I show the mail symbol here because this user datagram protocol UDP is not connection oriented, it's connection less. That means basically just send it out like chucking a letter into the mail and not having any tracking on it. You just hope it reaches the destination, but you don't know for sure whether it has or not. So that's TCP and UDP both at layer 4. Now let's have a look at all 7 layers. So at the bottom we've got the physical layer. Here of course we have the physical infrastructure like the cables and the networking devices. And we're communicating using bits here, ones and zeros basically. We've got coaxial, we've got fiber, we've got wireless technology, we've got the media, the signal and the binary transmission happening. Then at the data link layer, we've got frames. And this is Ethernet, 802.11 wireless as well, media access control. We've got physical addressing both the media access control and what's called logical link control as well, MAC and LLC. Then we've got the network layer. Here we're talking about packets. We've got IP, IP security, IPsec, and Internet Control Message Protocol, ICMP as well. So we can do things like ping at layer 3. And path determination is what's happening here. So routing, finding the best path to the destination. Then we have the transport layer, and here we refer to segments. We've got TCP, we've got UDP, and we've got transport layer security as well, TLS. So end-to-end connections, and in some cases reliability, not the case with UDP. At layer 5, we've got something called the session layer. Here we have data, we've got TCP, we've got remote procedure call, RPC, we've got that inter-host communication happening. Presentation layer, again it's data here, we've got SSL, we've got FTP, SSH, and HTML. So it's about data representation and encryption of that data. And then the last one, layer 7, is the application layer. So here again, we're referring to data and it's HTTP, FTP, SSH, and DNS. So now network services to end user applications. HTTP, of course, web servers, the internet is based on HTTP. So at layer 7, we've got information about those particular HTTP requests. Now, one way to remember this is how I was taught many years ago, is all people seem to need data processing. There's various other ones out there as well, but that starts off at the very top with application, presentation, session, transport, network, data link, and then physical. So just one way to remember it. Now, the last concept in this subject is TCP encapsulation. So this is where we're kind of putting it together and seeing what happens when data is transmitted. So at the very top here, we have the application layer. So we have some data. And what's happening is the computer wants to transmit this data. So what it has to do, it has to go down from the top down. It's taking the data and it's putting it into a segment with a TCP header on it. That has information about things like the port number to connect to. Then the IP layer goes on. It forms packets out of the data. So we've got the TCP header added on to the data. Now we add the IP header on, and that has the IP address of the destination. Then we have the data link layer. So now it's adding the Ethernet header as well, ready to put it onto the network to actually send this data out. And then lastly, at the physical layer, we have those ones and zeros being transmitted, and they can be transmitted in different ways, whether we're talking about fiber optics or whether we're talking about electronic signals. So that's it for an overview of the OSI model. Now, in the AWS cloud, the main places that we're going to focus are layer 3, layer 4, and layer 7. Layer 1, the physical layer, that's very much handled by AWS. The data link layer, layer 2, sure, we can modify MAC addresses, for example, on EC2, but most of the time we don't need to focus much on the data link layer. Network layer for sure, because we need to assign the IP addresses to our instances. We need to configure route tables, so IP addressing and routing is definitely within our scope of control. Layer 4, the transport layer, that's where we have ports, so that is important for as well for things like security groups, network ACLs to allow the correct connections to come through on the correct ports. And then layer 7 is where we have application load balancers, so we might want to, for example, forward based on information in an HTTP header. So 3, 4, and 7 are definitely the ones we focus on the most in the cloud.